It's pretty cool, right? So much information, so much history of the Earth is recorded in these sandstone and limestone walls, and in this video, we're going to discover just a few chapters from this epic book. You see those layers? They're the little pages in Earth's story. When you look at these cliffs, try to imagine lines that divide the different rock layers. They're dividing the rocks into different units. Got it? Alright. Over hundreds of millions of years of the Earth's plates shifting, millions of species coming into existence and dying out. Some of them still thrive, while some of them have the remains hidden locked away of the rocks of this Grand Canyon. But keep in mind, it took hundreds of millions of years for these rocks to deposit, right? Some of this stuff on the bottom, it's as old as 530 million years. Some of the stuff on top, it's about 270-ish million years old. Here's a little diagram of the rocks comprising the Grand Canyon and the ages associated with them. We're just focusing on these rocks above this line here. Look at how they're all kind of parallel to the ground. Basically, anything deposited under this line is about 740 million years and older. The biology on Earth was super simple compared to today. Just a bunch of colonies of single-celled organisms existed. And while they're important, it's not really the focus of this video. So, if we're just talking about these rocks, that's 250 million years of plate tectonics doing their thing, shifting everything around. The Earth changes drastically over this time scale. Check it out. Here's how the Earth's surface changed over the last 540 million years due to plate tectonics. Keep in mind, this movement is happening at painfully slow speeds, moving somewhere in the ballpark of half to 10 centimeters a year. Alright, so we'll play this again a bit slower, and there's a few cities marked on this map. The area that is the Grand Canyon is right about here. Over the majority of Earth's history, there is very little ice compared to today. Because of this, there are lots of areas that are submerged in water that are not submerged today. The area that comprises much of the interior United States was encompassed by giant seas in the intruding oceans. So now that we've got some context, let's look at these rocks again. These layers, known as the Tonto Group, were deposited in the Cambrian somewhere between 525 and 505 million years ago. The Earth was way different. Pretty much all complex life developed underwater. There were these things called trilobites that just scourged the bottom of the seafloor, hunting for tiny little worms. These guys are some of the earliest known arthropods, ancient ancestors to modern day spiders and centipedes. Keep in mind, life is relatively small in this age, except for the Anomalocaris, one of the earliest apex predators of Earth. It's thought these guys fed on trilobites and used their two frontal appendages to flip them over so they could attack their more vulnerable bottom side. These things had insane eyes too, with each eye comprised of about 16,000 lenses. It's thought these were the largest animals from the Cambrian, and some species come in at about a meter in length. Honestly, a little bit smaller than I would think just looking at pictures and videos of them. I think if my life depended on it, I could take one. I know, life back then was super sick, but let's take a few steps forward and go up the wall of the Grand Canyon to the Red Wall Limestone Formation. This stuff was deposited around 340 million years ago in the Carboniferous period. The oxygen in the atmosphere, it was at an all-time high. There were tons of land plants which contributed to the massive increase in oxygen in the atmosphere. And the invertebrates benefited from this increase in oxygen, and they got insanely huge. We're talking 6 feet long centipedes that'll eat your face off, known as Arthropleura, and dragonflies with a wingspan of up to 2.5 feet, known as Meganeura. I, for one, am stoked these are not around today. We've also got these cool guys named Temnospondyli. And I just gotta say, ooh, ooh, look at that fine specimen. These guys are important because they're some of the earliest vertebrates to fully adapt to life on land. And even though there's a lot of other cool things going on in the Carboniferous, we're gonna make our way to the Permian now, going up the sandstone till we hit the Kaibab Formation and Coconino Sandstone. These rocks were deposited around 270 to 280 million years ago in the Permian era, and this is the time period right before the dinosaurs started to exist. Around this time, there are some key skull characteristics that develop, which mark the split between the proto-reptiles and the proto-mammals. Check it out. We got the synapsids and the diapsids. The synapsids have one temporal opening. The mammals came from these guys. We got things like Dimetrodon. Ooh, look at that back, baby's got some back. It was thought that these spines were likely used for thermal regulation. The fossils for these guys are found nearby the Grand Canyon. Shout out to the red beds of Texas and Oklahoma. And we got the diapsids. We got birds and reptiles coming from these guys, and in their skull, two temporal openings. All the crocodiles, lizards, snakes, birds, they all came from these guys. An early diapsid thought to be living around this time is Hovosaurus, which was an early aquatic reptile. And these fossils were found with stones in their stomachs. And what they thought those stones were used for was maintaining buoyancy so they wouldn't float up to the surface while hunting prey. So yeah, the Grand Canyon is pretty sick. On top of the breathtaking physical beauty this park beholds, there's a deep history ingrained from the formation of these majestic cliffs. Hundreds of millions of years accumulating, grain by grain, the walls of history we are privileged enough to still enjoy today. If you ever get a chance to walk down the trails at this park, you'll maybe have a greater appreciation for the generations of life that have come before us and respect our future so the coming generations can walk down and enjoy this great novel of Earth's history. And that's all I got for you guys this time. If you guys enjoyed the video, feel free to leave a like, comment, maybe ask any kind of Earth-related questions you have. Thanks a lot, guys. See ya.